23rd January 1897 marks a historic day in India's story when Jankinath Bose and Prabhavati Devi were blessed with a child who would become one of the great figures in the battle for India's independence. The brilliant Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose since childhood was influenced by the ideals and ideas of Swami Vivekanand. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, who finished fourth in the civil services exams in England, resigned from his post after hearing of the horrific Jallianwala Bagh massacre. It is from this point that Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose joined the freedom struggle. Upon returning to India, influenced by Gandhiji and the civil disobedience movement, Netaji joined the Congress Party. In 1923, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose became the National President of the Youth Congress and the Secretary of the Bengal Congress. In 1925, he was sent to Mandalay Jail for participating in the freedom struggle. Soon after coming out of jail in 1927, he was appointed General Secretary of the Congress Party, and from here, the young brigade of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose quickly gained popularity across India and gave renewed momentum to not only the Congress but also the freedom movement. Both Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose and Pandit Nehru were in favor of Purna Swaraj, and this was the reason why both the young leaders opposed the dominion status proposed in 1928. In 1931, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was sent to jail again, but nothing, not even the prison bars, could weaken the resolve of Bharat Mata's brave son. In 1938, Netaji became the national president of the Congress Party.
India is going to be free, and that we, police today, are going to play a part in making India free.
During the lockdown of 1941, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose managed to leave India and form an army on foreign soil. The army, Azad Hind Fauj, had the sole purpose of fighting for India's freedom. The brigade was named after Mahatma Gandhi, Pandit Nehru and Maulana Azad. Standing on foreign land, he used the Dilli Chalo slogan to inspire his troops, and while doing so used the term Father of the Nation to refer to his beloved leader and seek his blessings. While his famous line, "You give me blood, I will give you freedom," was spoken on foreign land, it inspired and energized the youth fighting for freedom in India.
Gulami ki zanjeeron ko todne ke liye ek dil ek pran hokar katibadh ho jaiye. Hindustan ab gulam nahi reh sakta aur na koi taakat ise gulam rakhi sakti hai.
Today, even though Netaji is not with us, his ideals and values of patriotism and brotherhood continue to guide us. We have to come together to build the India that Netaji had dreamt of. This will be a fitting tribute for a nationalist hero and a true patriot. Jai Hind.